Okay, so now let's start with a new rule, rule 10. Understand what has happened? In rule 12, my value which I have declared in rule 11 has been accepted. So now I will be going to rule 3 plus rule 10. What is rule 3? Rule 3 is nothing but your transaction value. What is rule 3? Rule 3 is nothing but your transaction value. And now in that transaction value, you will have to do the adjustment which is given in rule 10. You will have to do the adjustment which is given in rule 10. I hope you're with me. Can I go ahead? Now, what is the transaction value? That's FOB value. Transaction value matlab FOB value, free on board value. That means this one. This is what? This is US port. This is USA port. And this is India port. This is India port. So basically, the FOB value, is equal to transaction value. And now I have to bring this FOB value to CIF value. For that, I need to do adjustment which is given in rule 10. And in 10, we have two subrules, 10 subrule 1 and 10 subrule 2. 10 subrule 1 and 10 subrule 2. Boss, understand, everywhere by default 10 subrule 1 will not be applicable. If it's given in the question, then only 10 subrule 1 will be applicable. But 10 subrule 2 will always be applicable if FOB value is given. If what is given? FOB value, because I know I have to pay duty on CIF value. I have to pay duty on CIF value and I have to convert this FOB value to CIF value, and to convert I need to add two expenses. One is insurance and second is transportation, loading, unloading, handling to the base of importation. After adding this two, I will be getting CIF value. What is CIF value? Cost, insurance, freight, and this two, insurance and freight, this two is explained in rule 10, subrule 2. So as of now, first we will be studying rule 10, subrule 2. Very important. Okay. Adjustments rule 10 in the transaction value, adjustment as per rule 10 subrule 2. Adjustment of cost of production. See, loading, unloading and handling charges. This is completely one name. Cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges and insurance charges. Two things. Transportation, cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges, and second is insurance charges. Let's go with this. Rule 10 subrule 2. Am I clear? This is an amendment, but yes, not very latest amendment. It's like two attempts back. The value of imported goods shall be the value of such goods for delivery at the time and place of importation. My section 14 subsection 1 is saying you need to pay import duty on the transaction value at the time and place of importation. So my place of importation is this India port. This is my place of importation. So I want value at this point. What need to be done? I need to add two expenses. One is cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges, and second is insurance cost. First one, cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges. You have to write the whole name in the exam. Just don't write cost of transportation. It is cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges. The cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of imported goods to, very important word, to the place of importation. Understand what they're trying to say? To the place of importation. Boss, once the goods are imported, this is like they need to leave post importation expenses. You are not going to pay duty on post importation expenses. You will be paying duty only to the place of importation. All the expenses incurred to the place of importation, only on that you are going to pay the duty. Only on that you will be paying the duty. So what they are trying to say over here is, cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges, the cost of transport, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of importation will be added. The cost of transportation, now let's go to proviso. Proviso means provision is the section. Proviso means exception to the provision. Am I clear? Proviso to provision. Proviso to provision means exception to the section. Cost of transportation, loading and unloading and handling charges is not ascertainable. Assume you don't know. Assume you are not aware of this. Where the cost referred to in 10.2a, cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of importation is not ascertainable. In such case, such cost will be 20% of the FOB value of the goods. Understand? I know my FOB value, but I don't know my cost of transportation. This I know. This I don't know. Loading, unloading, handling, I don't know. What to be done? Take 20% of FOB value. 20% of FOB value. Am I clear? Where the cost referring 10.2, I'm again reading it. Where the cost referring 10.2a is cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of importation is not ascertainable, such cost shall be 20% of FOB. Second, cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges where FOB value is not ascertainable. If you don't know the FOB value, but you know FOB plus cost of insurance. See, I don't know my actuals. My first point is saying FOB value is known. Take FOB is 20%. My second point is saying FOB value you don't know. You don't know FOB value, but you know FOB plus insurance. You don't have the breakup. You just know this X figure. You know this X figure. I hope you get my point. You know this X figure. I hope you get my point. Where the FOB value of the goods is not ascertainable, but sum of FOB value of goods and the cost of insurance to the place of importation and the cost of insurance to the place of importation is ascertainable. The cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of import shall be 20% of the sum. Boss, they have made our life simple. After these amendments, they have made the life very simple. Initially, before this amendment, there was actually calculation. But now, they have made it very clear. Do you know FOB? Yeah, I know FOB. Let's make a table. Let's try to make something graph. Let's write it like a... Okay. Cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling. First, ascertainable. That means I know. Not ascertainable. Not ascertainable. That means I don't know. If I know, simple. Take actuals. Take actuals, whatever is a ticket. If I don't know, FOB is known. FOB is known. Then what to be done? Take 20% of FOB. Simple. Second, FOB is not known. You don't know what is FOB, but you know FOB plus insurance is known. What to be done? Take 20% of FOB plus insurance. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. Now, see, important point. Air freight, air, only in case of air, cannot exceed 20% of FOB value of goods. For example, if FOB value is 1 lakh, so 1 lakh 20% is 20,000. Assume they have given my cost of transportation, my air freight is 30,000. So normally you should add 30. Normally you should add 30, but here you will not be adding 30. Here 30,000 or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. 30,000 or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. That means I'll be adding what? 1 lakh or 20%, that means 20,000 or 30,000, whichever is lower, I'll be taking 20,000. Am I clear? If actual is 15,000, if actual is 15,000, the 1 lakh or 20% is 20,000, 15,000 or 20,000, whichever is lower, I'll be adding 15,000. Air freight, may they have put restriction. Air freight cannot exceed 20% FOB value of the goods. In case of importation of goods by air, even if the actual cost of transport, loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of importation is ascertainable, we know, still the same shall not exceed 20% of FOB. That means in this diagram I can say ascertainable actuals, but in case of air, it is maximum 20% of FOB. Am I clear? Or actuals, whichever is lower. In case of only air, not in case of vessel, not in case of vehicle. Am I very clear? Okay. D point. Transshipment cost to be excluded. Boss, we know the meaning of the term transit. We know the meaning of the term transshipment. Am I clear? In case goods imported by sea or air and transshipped to another customs station in India, the cost of insurance, transportation, loading, unloading, handling charges associated with such transshipment will be excluded. Understand what is happening? I hope you know what is transshipment. Transshipment means, assume UK to Mumbai. Right? Basically, the goods were imported for Goa. Basically, the goods were imported for Goa. The importer was in Goa, but the vessel route was UK, Mumbai, Sri Lanka. So what importer did? Importer asked the person to unload the goods in Mumbai. To unload the goods in Mumbai, and in Mumbai, they have changed the vessel or aircraft. They have changed the vessel or aircraft, and from here they have taken the goods to Goa. Understand? I hope you're with me. Now understand, from year to year, this is called as what? This is called as transshipment. This is called as what? Transshipment. Transship. Change the ship, change the aircraft. Now what they're trying to say, in case goods imported by sea or air and transshipped to another custom station in India. From one custom station in India to another custom station in India, the cost of insurance as well as transport, loading, unloading and handling charges with such transshipment will not be shall be excluded, that means will not be included. Why? Because honestly, they're trying to say once the goods have entered India, na Mumbai, India, then from Mumbai to Goa, the expenses will not be added in the value. Am I clear? This is really important. Am I clear? This is really important. Can I go ahead? Am I clear? What's next? Ship demurrage charges on chartered vessels, litterage or barrage charges includable. See, we already studied there's something called as daughter vessel, mother vessel. I hope you with me. Now assume on this boat, the water level is very less or there's no berth. So my mother vessel is far away. Now I want to bring the goods from that place to the port. So what will I be doing? I will be sending. Let's take a diagram over here. Assume this is my port. This is my port and my vessel is here. My vessel is here and the water level here is very less. The water level here is very less, as well as another reason, maybe there's no berth. There's no berth. So now my goods are here. I want to bring my goods here to the port. What will I do? I will send small ships. Small ships. This big ship is called as mother vessel. And these are called as daughter vessel. These are called as daughter vessel. Now what is going to happen? This daughter vessel will go to mother vessel. Mother vessel will unload the goods on the daughter vessel. And daughter vessel will bring the goods to the place. To the place of importation. Logically think now. Tell me, all the expenses from daughter vessel to mother vessel and from mother vessel back to the port, shouldn't that be included? Yes. Any expenses to the place of importation. Isn't this part of my transportation? Loading, unloading. What will happen? From mother vessel, unloading will be done to daughter vessel. Am I clear? From, are you with me? Mother vessel, say you're going to unload. There will be loading in daughter vessel. Then daughter vessel will unload on the port. Handling would need to be done. Transportation need to be done. Is all this expenses is to the place of importation? Yes or no? Yes or no? All the expenses are to the place of importation. All such things will be added to the value, added to cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges. Am I clear? The cost of transport of imported goods referred above includes ship demurrage charges on charter vessel, litterage or barrage charges. This all will be added in the value. Am I clear? So this was my first point, which talks about cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges. Am I clear? Simple. Actuals are given, take actuals. But in case of air, actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. Okay. If actuals are not given, FOB value is given, take 20% of FOB. Okay. If actuals are not given, FOB is also not given, but you know FOB plus insurance. You know the sum. So take FOB plus insurance 20%. Am I clear? Then they said, okay, transshipment expenses from where? From one custom station in India to another custom station in India, that expenses will not be included. Then they said, ship demurrage charges on chartered vessels or litterage or barrage charges will be added. This is basically linked to mother vessel and daughter vessel. All this will be added because these are the expenses which are incurred to bring the goods to the place of importation. Clear? Now let's go to the next one. In 10-2, there are two. One is cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges, and another one is insurance charges to the place of importation. The cost of insurance to the place of importation. Cost of insurance, if actuals are there, very good, add actuals. If actuals are not there, take FOB values 1.125%. If actual cost of insurance is given, take actuals. If actual cost of insurance is given, take actuals. If actuals are not given, then if FOB value is given, take 1.125% of FOB. Okay, B. Cost of insurance when FOB value is not ascertainable. I am not aware of the FOB value, but I know cost. I know what? I know two things. I know FOB value plus cost of transportation, loading, unloading, handling charges. In that case, if I know the sum, take sums 1.125%. Where FOB value of the goods is not ascertainable, but the sum of FOB value of the goods and the cost of transport, loading and unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods to the place of importation is ascertainable. What need to be done? The cost of insurance to the place of importation shall be 1.125% of such sum. Am I clear? Is rule 10 sub-rule 2 very clear? Two things. First talks about cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges. Second talks about cost of insurance. All only to the place of importation has to be considered. Am I clear? Now, just for the knowledge, there was this is an amendment. This circular has come, circular number 39 by 2017, customs dated 26 September 2017. See, what was happening before this circular? What was happening before this circular? I'll tell you. Take FOB value. What was happening before, earlier, erstwhile, not now. Then, transportation actuals. Only restriction in case of air freight. Second, insurance actuals. This comes to be CIF, and then it was handling, loading, unloading, etc., which was 1% of CIF. This together was my assessable value. This was my assessable value. 1% of CIF. That means this was a notional figure. This was notional figure. Notional amount. Then, in case law, Wipro Limited, they went to Supreme Court and they said that, sir, why are you taking notional? Why are you taking 1% of CIF? Why aren't you taking the actuals? This was the intention of going to Supreme Court. This was the intention of going to the Supreme Court. Then why are you taking notional? Take actuals. This was the intention. But because of this, they came up with a very good judgment. Supreme Court saying that I should not add any expenses which is done at the port, India port. Boss, this is my India. This is my India port. India. To bring here to any expenses done to should be added at. Should be not added because you have to pay custom duty on the value at the time and place of importation. Your place of importation is India. Once it has reached India, after reaching India, whatever expenses you are doing, they are post-importation expenses which should not be added. And because of this, they came with a very good judgment. They have changed the whole rule 10 by saying that we are going to add only those expenses which are incurred to the place of importation and not at the place of importation. After this judgment, the importance of to and the importance of at is very much there. To bring something to India, you need to add it. But something is at India, expenses incurred at the port will not be added. Am I clear? I hope you're with me. See what's written. The Honorable Supreme Court had ruled in the case of Mrs. Wipro Limited versus Assistant Collector of Customs, dated so and so, that the landing charges to be added to the value of goods should be based on actual basis. Basically, they have gone for this. Why notional? Take actuals. Landing charges. It was landing charges. It was landing at India. To be added in the value of goods should be based on actual basis and not on notional charges of 1%. It was 1% of CIF. By virtue of the amendment now carried out, the loading, unloading and handling charges associated with the delivery of the imported goods at the place of import shall no longer be added to the CIF value. Shall no longer be added to the CIF value. The phrase loading, unloading and handling charges appearing in the amendment rule 10-2A is to be understood in context of this article. The cost of insurance, sorry, the cost of transportation of imported goods to the port or place of importation. 2. Thus, only charges incurred for delivery of goods to the place of importation, such as loading, unloading, such as loading and handling incurred at, shall not be included in the transaction value. Any expenses incurred at the port will not be added. Only the expenses incurred to bring it to the port will be added. Am I very clear? Am I clear? Can I go ahead? So because of this, the whole new rule has come into picture. You already read the new rule, so no need to read this. Just keep in mind that Wipro case. Am I clear? Just keep in mind that Wipro case. Am I clear? Am I clear? So no need to read this fourth and fifth point unless you get confused. It's just that you should know what was the base. We've already studied in depth. Am I clear? Is rule 10, sub rule 2 very, very clear? Can I go ahead? Can I start with another rule 10, sub rule 1? Okay, can I start? Okay. Okay, so now let's go to rule 10, sub rule 1. Rule 10, sub rule 1. Now understand. Rule 10, sub rule 1 by default will not be there. Understand the concept behind rule 10, sub rule 1. See, normally, all the expenses for the production of the goods will be incurred by the supplier or with the exporter. And whatever he has incurred, that is his cost. And on that cost, he will add his profit margin and he will give it to me at that price. Agreed or not? For example, exporter will incur everything. Cost of production, everything incurred by him only, and his profit margin he will add, and at this price he is going to sell. This is the FOB price, right? This is what I've paid. So as an importer, this is what I have paid. As an importer, this is what I have paid. Nothing other than this. But assume there is some expenses which had to be done by exporter. Which had to be done by exporter, but which has been done by me as an importer. Which has been done by me as an importer. Now, that much expenses will not be added in his cost production. Because when he has not incurred, his cost is not, he has not spent anything on it. So, yes, he won't add in his cost. Are you with me? I hope you're with me. But practically, tell me how much I have paid. I must have paid whatever cost he must have incurred plus his profit margin plus that expense which had to be incurred by the exporter but which has been incurred by me. This is the way people can try to evade tax. This is the way people can try to evade tax. Evasion can be done. People can plan it out. Okay, let's do one thing. For example, exporter will say my costing is 10 lakhs, my profit is 2 lakhs, so 12 lakhs is what you're going to give me, right? This is one, there's no evasion. But another way exporter can say me, so okay, my cost is 10 lakhs, in that X commission you pay on my behalf, You pay on my behalf. Okay. Assume that commission is for 3 lakhs. So I as an importer has paid 3 lakhs as a commission, which had to be paid by whom? The exporter. If exporter would have paid that commission, he would have added in his cost. His cost would have been 10 lakhs, but now because he has not paid, so his cost will be 7 lakhs. And then 7 lakhs, suppose he's adding his profit 2 lakhs, total comes to 9 lakhs. So what would be seen that I have paid how much? 9. But actually I have not paid 9. I have paid 9 plus 3. So what need to be done? This 9 lakhs, FOB as per question is 9 lakhs. FOB given is 9 lakhs. In this 9 lakhs, I need to do rule 10, subrule 1 adjustments first. I'll be doing rule 10, subrule 1 adjustment first. Suppose I've added what? Commission, which comes to 3 lakhs. The total comes to 12 lakhs. This 12 lakhs is custom FOB. See, understand practically. If they would have not done this understanding, I would have end up paying 12 lakhs only. If he would have not asked me to pay this 3 lakh rupees, who would have paid that? That amount would have paid by the exporter himself. And if when he would have paid that amount, he would have added in his cost. The actual FOB should be 12 lakhs. But just by manipulation or whatever you want to say, anything, whatever you want to say, okay, I have no wrong means, okay, no malevolent intention, okay, but still, custom FOB should be 12 lakhs. Am I clear? So when I will do 10-2 adjustments rule, 10 subrule 2 adjustments, it will be on this 12 lakhs and not on 9 lakhs. Assume if in the question, no transportation cost is given and I have to take 20% of FOB. I will be taking 20% of 12 lakhs and not 20% of 9 lakhs. That will be wrong. See, this 3 lakhs, though I have paid to whom as a commission, but this had to be paid by the exporter. And if he would have paid it, he would have incurred that cost. He would have added that cost to the value. Am I clear? So this is the way people can try to manipulate. So in 10, rule 10, subrule 1, they have given us how many adjustments? They have given us 8. How many adjustments? 8. And the list of 8 is exclusive list. That means there will be no 9 point. But if you see the 8 point, any payment by importer on behalf of the supplier to any person is required to be added. When I say any means, it includes all. So basically 8th point includes, 8th point is etc. 8th point is etc. You have 1 to 7 specific points. You have 1 to 7 specific points. Basic understanding is, these expenses had to be done by exporter, but has been done by importer, and this is not added in the value. If it's already added, no need to add it again. But if it's not added, you have to add it. Who had to incur this? Exporter had to incur this. Who had incurred? Importer. You need to add it in the value as per rule 10, subrule 1. So let's come to first one. First one, commission or brokerage. Commission or brokerage. Payable in India, in Indian rupees, or abroad in foreign currency. Commission paid in India, commission paid in foreign country. All commission will be added. Commission, who had, suppose this was a commission which had to be paid by exporter. But who has paid? Importer. In India or abroad, wherever, this commission need to be added, except, but if it's a buying commission, then it is not to be added. If it's a buying commission, now what is buying commission? Understand? Suppose what I'm asking you to add. I am asking you to add those expenses which had to be done by exporter but done by importer. That expenses need to be added. But the expenses which has to be done by importer only, that was importer per se expenses and he has done that. The question of adding that in the value will not come into picture. This is buying commission. Now what is buying commission? Assume I want to import goods from US. Now I don't know anybody over there. I want to buy stuff from UK. I don't know anybody. I don't know a supplier. So assume I have appointed you as my agent. I have appointed you as my agent and I've asked you to please help me in buying this goods. And if you help me in buying this goods, I will pay you buying commission. Now tell me, simple. Was this buying commission had to be paid by exporter? No. Who had to pay it? Importer. Is importer paid? Yes. Do you need to add in the value? No. Am I clear? Except buying commission, you have to add all type of commission, maybe paid in India in INR or foreign country in their currency. It has to be added except only buying commission will not be added. Clear? So refer note below on buying commission. What I have just explained you, what is the meaning of buying commission, is written over that you can read on your own. Second, cost of container. If container is returnable, as in that means you have given me a container and I have to return you back, then the cost of container will not be added. Logic. Understand the logic. Suppose you are an exporter, you have purchased a container and that container is reusable. How can you add the whole cost of the container to my value? You will be amortizing it. Am I clear? But if it's not returnable, it has to be added. Very simple. Third, packing charges. Whatever packing charges, basically who has to incur packing charges? Exporter. Who have incurred? Importer. Am I very clear? Need to be added. Packing charges to be added, whether for labor or for materials. Fourth, materials, tools, molds, dies supplied from India. That means who has supplied this? Importer. Now, think practically. Suppose you are an exporter and you are giving me 10 lakh rupees plus your profit margin 2 lakh, which comes to 12 lakhs. One scenario. Second scenario, I am into button business. I have button. That's buttons are raw material. So I have asked you, don't buy a button from somebody else. I will give you button free of cost. Now, have you paid for the button? No. When you have not paid for the button, will you add button cost in the total cost? No. Assume button amounts to 1 lakh rupee. Have you paid? As an exporter, have you paid? No. So what is your costing? Now it won't be 10 lakhs, it will be 9 lakhs. 9 plus 2, 11 lakhs would be the profit. So 11 lakhs would be the total value. But tell me, is 11 correct? No, this 1 lakh of button I have given you free of cost. It should also be added. Basically, I'm giving you 11 lakh rupees also. I'm giving you button also. If I'm giving you materials, tools, molds, dies, etc., supplied from India, free of cost, free, completely free, full value would be added. Suppose I'm giving you completely free, the value was 1 lakh. You need to add whole 1 lakh. If not free, I have given you a concession. I have given you in 40,000. That means you have paid how much? 40. See, normal cost was 10. Profit was 2. It should be 12. FOB should be 12. But here you have not paid for the button anything. So your cost is 9 lakhs. Plus your profit is 2 lakhs. Which comes to 11 lakhs. This is the FOB given the question. I will be adding 1 lakh over here as per rule 10, sub rule 1, and I will bring it to 12 lakhs if completely free. Here, I am not giving you free, I am charging 40,000. So basically, you have paid 40,000, it will be 9 lakh 40,000 your cost. Your profit is 2 lakh rupees. So total comes to 11,40,000 rupees. Now tell me, is a button worth only 40? No, button is worth 60. Button is worth 1 lakh. I have given you a concession of 60,000. Whatever concession I have given you need to be added, which comes to 12 lakhs. Anyway, the answer will come 12 lakhs. All this will be coming into 10 subrule 1. Am I very clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. Fifth point. Engineering, design, development, art, work. See, for the fourth point talk about materials. The fifth point talk about the services. Goods and services. Services here. If done in India, then the cost is not to be added. It is engineering, designing, development, artwork, plan and sketches is done in India. It is not to be added. If done in abroad and necessary for the production of the imported goods, then the cost should be added. Am I clear? Is fifth point clear? Come to sixth point. A really good point. Royalty. See, now you have to listen a little bit, understand in depth. Royalty and the license fees related to the imported goods the buyer is required to pay directly or indirectly as a condition for sale of goods being valued to the extent same is not included in the price actually paid or payable. See, understand? Simple. Whatever the buyer has to pay to execute the sale, to execute this import, all has to be part of the value. So if buyer has paid what royalty? Royalty and license fees related to the imported goods that the buyer is required to pay directly or indirectly as a condition of sale. That's a condition that without paying royalty, sale will not be executed. Without paying royalty, that means royalty is a condition for sale. As a condition for sale of the goods being valued, to extend the same is not included in the value has to be added. Simple point. Now they have given some interpretation notes regarding this. Nature and scope of royalty as per interpretative notes. Further, this notes provides the following. Royalty and license fees may include other things like patents, copyrights and trademarks. Basically, just not restricted to royalty. Any intangible assets, and for that you're paying royalty, you're paying patent, you're paying trademark, you're paying copyrights, you will have to add everything. Second point. Royalty charge for reproduction will not be included. Reproduction. Reproduction royalty will not be included. Don't worry, we'll be studying in depth below. We'll be studying the case law in the below. However, the charges for right to reproduce the imported goods in the country of importation shall not be added to the price actually paid or payable for determining the custom value. So now the question comes, ma'am, what do you mean by reproduction? Come to second case law. Second case law, State Bank of India. In the similar matter of State Bank of India, the SBI has imported a software consisting of 46 disks for use in all the branches of the bank in India. What they have done? They have imported 46 software consisting of 46 disks. Okay. What they have paid? Value of the disk is $14,300. License fees for use of the software one place is $3 lakh. License fee for use of the software countrywide is $35 lakh. Total SBI paid $38,14,300. Okay. SBI argued that custom duty is payable only on $3,14,300. The license fee of 35 lakhs shall not be added in the value of the goods as this amount has been paid for reproduction of the software in India. See what they have done, they have just imported one set of disk. As a one set means there's a set of 46 disk. So what that can be used only in one place. To be used in different place of SBI, they need to make copies of it. So they are saying that we are going to reproduce what is being said by SBI. They are saying that we are going to reproduce it, and we are paying the 35 lakhs for reproduction, and for reproduction that amount will not be added in the value. It's just conveyed above, so that should not be added. This was conveyed by SBI. Okay, what was SBI saying? The license fee of $35 lakh shall not be added in the value of goods, as this amount has been paid for reproduction of software in India so that all the branches can use it. The royalty paid for reproduction in India is not included in the assessable value, and hence duty is payable only on $314,300. This is what they said. The department argued that $35 lakh is not paid for reproduction. Mark this line. Crux. Department argued that $35 lakh is not paid for reproduction, but paid for use of license in India. Okay, now what Supreme Court did? Supreme Court has given a superb answer. They have explained us the meaning of the term reproduction. The Supreme Court held that there is a difference between reproduction of goods and use of goods. The court held that software has been imported for 38 lakhs $14,300 for use in all branches in India. Only one copy of the software is imported into India, and the multiple copies are being made in India to be used at various branch offices in India. The bank is not authorized to sell the software or use the software at any place other than the branch office. Mark this now. It cannot be considered as reproduction of software, as the term reproduction indicates producing copies of imported goods for sale. When you're making copies to sale, that is called as reproduction. When you're making copies in India to further sale, that is called as reproduction. But here you are not making copies for sale, here you are making copies for reuse. But such reproduction is not involved in the present case. Here the copies of the software are being made solely for the purpose of use of the software by all SBI branches. The difference between reproduction and reuse must be appreciated. Therefore, the license fee paid for use of software not being reproduction's royalty shall be added in the value of the software, and hence the custom duty shall be paid on $38,14,300. Simple. That 35 lakhs is not reproduction royalty. Reproduction means you are making copies to sell it. That's what is reproduction. But here you are making copy to reuse it. That is not reproduction, and they have excluded in the interpretation notes the word reproduction. Am I clear? Next. Payment for redistribution or reselling not included. See what's written. Payment made by the buyer for the right to redistribute or resell the imported goods shall not be added to the price actually paid or payable for the imported goods if such payment are not a condition for sale of export to the country of importation of the imported goods. Understand what they're trying to say? See this third point. It depends on case to case. If this reselling, if I'm paying some royalty for reselling or redistribution, and without making that payment, this import cannot be executed. That means it's a condition for sale. When it is a condition for sale, I need to add it. When it is not a condition for sale, I will not add it. That means if I don't pay this royalty, you won't allow me to import. Then I need to add. But if I pay or not pay, it does not matter. You will allow me to import, redistribution or resell something else. Am I clear? Something which is a condition for sale has to be added. Second point depends upon case to case, what facts are given in the question. Am I clear? Is all clear? Come to seventh point. Any subsequent sale process to be payable to the supplier. If you remember when we were studying rule 3, there were four cases. I have purchased raw material from, I have imported the raw material and I had to convert into finished goods. And the supplier had asked me, whatever finished goods you make, or then you sell, whatever you get, 10% of the proceeds you need to give to me. So if subsequent sale proceeds, what I am going to sell it further, if I know the sale proceed, so I can add it in 10, subrule 1. But if I don't know, I won't be able to add it. Am I clear? And 8, any other expenses which had to be incurred by, which had to be done by supplier, which has had been done by importer and is not added in the value will have to be added. So this is rule 10, subrule 1. This is rule 10, subrule 1. You will be given in the question FOB. In that FOB, first do the adjustments of rule 10, subrule 1. That will be called as custom FOB. That will be called as custom FOB. And on that custom FOB, do rule 10, subrule 2 adjustments. Am I clear? 10-1 done. 10-2 done. Let's come to 10-3. What is 10-3? Additions to the price actually paid or payable shall be made under this rule on the basis of objective and quantifiable data that is based on proper figures and appropriate assumptions. So simple, rule 10 can be applied only when I know the data. When I don't know the numbers, then rule 10 can't be applied. If rule 10 cannot be applied, that means I cannot go with rule 3 plus rule 10. My value will get rejected. I'll have to go to rule 4 to rule 9 sequentially. If the value of above adjustments cannot be quantified, then rule 10 cannot be applied and hence transaction value of rule 3 cannot be accepted. The goods shall be valued as per rule 4 to rule 9 proceeding sequentially. That means 10-3 saying, if you know the figures, proper figures, and you have appropriate assumptions, then only rule 10 will apply. And if rule 10 will apply, then only transaction value will be acceptable. But if rule 10 cannot be applied, forget transaction value also. You'll have to go from 4 to 9 sequentially. Then last, rule 10, subrule 4. No addition shall be made to the price actually paid or payable in determining the value of input rule except as provided in this rule. What they're saying? Whatever adjustments rule 10 has given, you have to add only those adjustments. Okay, 10 to a specific, only 2. Cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges to the place of importation and cost of insurance to the place of importation. But if I say rule 10, subrule 1, the 8th point, any payment by importer on behalf of the supplier to any other person has to be added. When I say any, it becomes all. Am I clear? So is rule 10 very clear? So see this FO chart, very important, to determine the assessable value after adjustments of rule 10. FOB price which is given in the question. Then do 10-1 adjustments. After doing 10-1 adjustments, you will get custom FOB. You will get custom FOB and on this custom FOB, you will be doing transportation and insurance adjustment. By after doing this, then you'll be getting what? CIF value. Am I very clear to you? Yes. That means we're done with rule 3. We are done with rule 10. We are in a position to solve the questions. And boss, 80% chances of rule 3 plus rule 10 in the exam. 20% is other rules. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. So now let's start with few illustrations. Very simple questions. Little bit you have to just emphasize on the topic, on the points. Compute the assessable value. Compute the assessable value from the following information. FOB value of the machine is 1 lakh UK pounds. Cost of insurance, cost of transportation, loading and unloading, and handling charges associated with the delivery of imported goods is not ascertainable. Simple. Boss, FOB value is given, my life is simple. If FOB value is given, my cost of transportation will be 20% of FOB. That means 20,000 UK pounds. Am I clear? 20,000 UK pounds. And if insurance is not given, actual is not given, but if FOB is given, my insurance will be 1.125% of FOB, which will be 1125 pounds. Okay, third point. I hope second point is clear. Third point, unloading and handling charges at, I have already made myself very clear, to the place of importation, expenses will be added. At the place of importation, things will not be added, irrelevant information. Am I clear? Exchange rate as notified by CBC or CBIC is 100 rupees, 100 per UK pound. So my FOB is 1 lakh pounds. That I will add what? Transportation, loading, unloading, and handling charge, which comes to 20,000. Then cost of insurance, which comes to 1125. Together, my CIF value is now 121125 into 100 exchange rate. So my CIF value in Indian rupees is 1211250. Clear? Very simple question. Okay. Note. Boss, important. Why are you not considering something? Always, why are you considering something? Always, you need to give the notes. Unloading and handling charges at the place of importation at shall not form part of the assessable value. Is question number one clear? Let's go to next illustration. Compute assessable value from the following information. FOB is $10,000. Air freight. Circle the word air freight. Why? In case of air, 20% of FOB or actuals, whichever is lower. 20% of FOB or actual, whichever is less. Air freight, loading, unloading, and handling charges associated with the delivery of imported goods to the place of importation is $2,500. If you don't emphasize the word air freight, you will add this 2,500. What need to be done? 10,000, 20% is $2,000 or actual is $2,500. Whichever is less is $2,000 will be added. Okay. Insurance given, easy. Unloading and handling charges at the place of importation of no use, irrelevant information. CBIC has given 65 rupees rate. $1.65. So in short, take 10,000 at 2,000. See, if I've added 2,000, you need to write the reason. And in case of air, actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is low, which comes to 2,000. Insurance, 500 actuals. CIF value is 12,500 in dollars. Exchange rate as per CBIC is 65 rupees. Total comes to 8,12,500 rupees. Am I clear? Any problem? Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Again, write the note. Unloading and handling charges at the place of importation shall not form part of the assessable value of goods. Can I go ahead? Third illustration. Compute the assessable value. FOB machine is $10,000. Air freight, loading, unloading, handling associated with the delivery to the place of importation is 1,000. 10,000. FOB is how much? 10,000. 10,000, 20% is $2,000 or $1,000. whichever is lower as 1000, so year will be added this only. Okay, cost of insurance is not given. Am I worried? No, cost of insurance is not given, but FOB is given. FOB is 1.125% of FOB will be my insurance. Am I clear? Am I clear? Am I clear? What will be my insurance? My insurance is 1.125% of FOB. Fourth point. Unloading and handling just at least concerned. In short, take FOB value 10,000, add 1,000. Why? Actual is 1,000. 20% is 2,000. Whichever is lower is 1,000. Then, though cost of insurance is not given, but I have FOB which is 1.125% of this 10,000, which comes to 112.50. After adding this, will be given 10 CIF value. Then convert the CIF value, which is given in dollars in INR, by multiplying by exchange rate given by CBIC. Simple question, not difficult at all. Okay, same, give the note. Am I clear? Come to fourth illustration. FOB value of the machine is not ascertainable. Oh my god, FOB value is not given. But FOB value of machine and air freight together, this is 15,000. Okay. Right? Cost of insurance is not given. We've already studied. If cost of insurance is not given, take FOB is 1.125%. If FOB is also not given, but what is given? FOB plus transportation is given. Then take this 1.125% of 15,000. Am I clear? That means I have FOB plus transportation, and by this I can calculate insurance also. So together I have my CIF value. Am I clear? Unloading charges at the place I am least bothered. So what will be the solution? Take FOB value plus transportation as 15,000. Then add cost of insurance. If actual is given, add actuals. If actual is not given, take FOB is 1.125%. If FOB is also not given, but FOB plus transportation is given, take sums 1.125%, which comes to 168.75. You go to CIF value, convert the CIF into INR by multiplying with the exchange rate given by CBIC. Am I very clear? Again, you need to write the what note. Am I clear? Very simple question, so it's going very fast. Illustration 5. Compute the assessable value. FOB of the value is not given. Air freight is not given. Now, air freight. What is air freight? Actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower, right? Air freight is not given. FOB is not given. But FOB plus insurance is given as 15,000. See, in case of air, actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. Neither do I have actuals, nor do I have FOB. What need to run? Directly take 15,000 20%. 15,000 20%, which comes to 3,000. I hope you're with me. This is an important question. Here you may get confused. This is important. Am I clear? Here you may get confused. You may think, you start applying your maths, please, nothing like that. They've clearly said, if FOB is given, take FOB is 20% or actual, whichever is less. Neither I have actuals, neither do I have FOB. How to calculate the 20%? Directly go to FOB plus insurance total and take that 20%. Am I clear? 18,000 is your CIF value. Convert the CIF value into your INR. Am I very clear? Is illustration 5 clear? Am I clear till here? Sure. Can I go ahead? Okay. So now let's go to next illustration. Illustration number 6. Computation of assessable value and custom duty. Given following information. Again, I hope you remember FOB, we have taken FOB. Then we will take rule 10 sub rule 1 adjustments. Then after doing that, we get custom FOB. And on the custom FOB, we will be doing rule 10 sub rule 2 adjustments. And after that, we will be getting CIF value. And then CIF value is my assessable value. And on that, I am going to calculate what? Custom duty. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. FOB value of machine is 8000 UK pounds. Okay. Fret. Air. We know that. Fret normally it should be actuals. But in case of air fret, actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. Okay. We'll see afterwards. Because this fret will come to 10.2. I hope you're with me. This fret comes to 10.2. Am I clear? Okay, design and development charges paid in UK. We have studied in 10.1. If design and development charges paid in India, then it is not added. But if it's paid other than like outside India, it will be added. This is 10.1 adjustment. Okay, commission payable to local agent. We studied any type of commission will be added except buying commission. Except buying commission. But now, this commission they are giving in 2% of FOB in Indian currency. We'll see how to do it. Then, okay, date of bill of entry they have given. Date of arrival of aircraft they have given. Integrated tax rate they have given. Insurance charge is actually paid but details are not available. We know that even if details are not available, we can take 1.125% of FOB. Am I clear? Okay, now, most important is to calculate the FOB. See, understand, we have been given, see, they have given a presentation. We'll see how to present if we want to change the presentation. 8000 is the FOB in pounds. Then you have to take 10.1 adjustment, that is design and development charges, which is 500 pounds, which comes to 8500. Now we have to add commission, but commission is in Indian currency, so you need to first convert this 8500 into INR, and we studied that for that we need exchange rate. An exchange rate we will be taking our first bill of entry. The date of bill of entry is 24 October, and that day exchange rate was 200 rupees per UK pound. Okay, just cut this 200 and write the 100. Okay. 100 rupees per UK pound, which comes to 8,50,000 rupees. 8,50,000 rupees. Now, most important thing, commission in on to the agent. 2% of FOB. 2% of what? This 8,000. Am I clear? So 8,000 into 100 into 100, and for that 2% will come to 16,000. So now your custom FOB is 8,66,000, and now on that you'll have to apply insurance as 1.125% of custom FOB. That means of 8,66,000. Please see one mistake. What all mistake you can do in this question? First mistake, 2% of what? 2% of FOB. FOB means the one which is given the question. Custom FOB will come after 10.1 adjustments. Custom FOB will come after 10.1 adjustments. I hope you get my point. Custom FOB will come after 10.1 adjustments. This is 10.1 adjustment. Am I clear? I've converted into INR and now I am multiplying. I'm 2% of FOB in INR, which comes 16,000. So my custom FOB is 8,66,000 rupees. Am I clear? Now insurance, what they're trying to say is actuals are not given. When actuals are not given, 1.125% custom FOB, which comes to 9,742. Then air freight actuals or 20% of custom FOB, whichever is lower. Actuals or custom FOB, whichever is lower. I hope you're with me. Yes, I hope you're with me. Get my point? So it will come to, if I convert this into, this will come to 2500 in 200 comes to 2,50,000. 2,50,000, that means my actual is how much? My actual is 250,000, but I am restricted to 20% of 866. So my CIF value, which is nothing but my assessable value, is 10,48,943 rupees. Now on this I have to calculate custom duty. Boss, custom duty we already studied in the chapter types of custom duty. Order is very important. First you need to apply BCD, basic custom duty. Now basic custom duty, what rate we studied? Date of arrival of aircraft or date of presentation of bill of entry, whichever is later. Bill of entry was presented on 24th of October. Arrival of aircraft is 20th of October. I hope you're with me. Understand, this is covered in upcoming lectures. It will be there in upcoming lectures. But just pay attention. What date custom duty are we going to consider? Date of bill of entry or arrival of aircraft, whichever is later, 24th October or 20th October, whichever is later, is 24th of October, that days 10%. Am I clear? And 37 is 12%. Okay, so let's see this. You'll have to take 10,48,942.50, 10%, which comes to 1,04,894. On that, second, you have to apply social welfare surcharge at the rate of 10% of BCD. Social welfare surcharge is on tax. The 10% of 1,04,894 comes to 10,419. After adding this three, you will be getting 11,64,325, and on that you will be applying integrated tax as per rule 3 sub rule 7. Am I clear? What percentage? 12%. It's already given the question, which comes to 1,39,719. So total imported cost comes to 13,04,044 rupees. Are you with me? Your CIF value was 10,48,000. You have imported in 13 lakh. That means you have paid custom duty 2,55,103 rupees. Am I very clear? Am I very clear? Sure. Can I go ahead? See, boss, what need to be done? Whenever you're doing some question, and see, understand, there's a way of studying in CA or any competitive exams. Now, tomorrow is your paper. So when tomorrow is your paper, you cannot keep on solving every question. So what need to be done is, you judge in every question what new points are added. See, every question will not be completely new. There will be only one or two adjustments which will be new. So what need to be done? Identify those adjustments, mark it by highlighter. So tomorrow is your exam, and today what you need to revise. So if in this question, what you need to revise is the design and development charges, the commission payable, and what rate of BCD you're going to consider. Am I very clear? Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Is last session 6 clear? Okay, whatever you do, boss, whatever you do, if you don't write notes, directly 50% marks are deducted. If your answer is even correct, you won't get full marks, because assume paper checker is not knowing anything. Assume paper checker does not know anything. If this is the mindset, you solve a question, write as if he doesn't know anything and you're trying to tell him everything. Whatever you are doing, why you are taking X, why you are taking Y, why aren't you not taking X? Write each and every working note and give the reference in the question. Answer. Am I clear? Okay. Come to next illustration. Illustration number 7. Care Energy Limited imported a lift from England at an invoice price of 20 lakhs. The assessee had supplied raw material worth rupees 5 lakh to the supplier for the manufacture of said lift. Again, this is 10-1 adjustment. See, the invoice what he has given is 20 lakhs. If I would have not given him the raw material of 5 lakh, who would have purchased? Care Energy would have purchased. See, the England person would have purchased on his own. if he would have purchased on his own, he would have not charged me 20 lakhs. He would have charged me 25 lakhs. Simple, yeah, simple. I hope you get the point. Suppose I have to manufacture the whole lift. So whatever I will incur, I will add in my invoice plus my profit margin. So now when you have given me raw material, that is not my cost. But it is not my cost, why will I add to my cost? If I will not add to my cost, I won't add profit margin to that amount. And I won't add that amount to my invoice. But basically tell me, what have you given me? You have given me 20 lakh rupees as well as raw material worth 5 lakhs. Basically, you have given me two things. Raw material worth 5 lakhs and 20 lakh rupees. So this raw material will come under rule 10 sub rule 1 adjustment. Okay. To a supplier for manufacture of said lift. Due to safety reasons, the lift was not taken to a jetty in the port, but was unloaded at the outer anchorage. See, jetty is like the port. Safety reason, maybe water level is not that high, maybe there is no berth, maybe any safety reasons. So the vessel is not at the port. Understand, we already studied. I will have to pay custom duty at the time and place of importation. I will have to pay custom duty at the time and place of importation. This is my port. So this, at this point, whatever is the value, on that value I will be paying GST. Yes or no? So not GST, customs. I'll have to pay customs. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Now what are they trying to say? Due to safety reasons, the lift was not taken to the jetty in the port, but was unloaded at the outer anchorage. It was year only. Okay. The charges incurred for such unloading amounted to rupees 25,000. To unload year, 25,000 rupees. Sorry, you're not able to see this. First, for unloading, you have incurred 25,000 rupees. Okay, what's next? And the cost incurred to transport of the lift from outer anchorage to jetty was 50,000. To bring from year to year, you have incurred 50,000. Okay, next. The importer was also required to pay ship demurrage charges. Ship demurrage charges, you have to pay ship demurrage charges also. Okay. The lift was imported at actual cost of transportation. Actual cost was 45,000 to bring it to Leo. Now tell me, isn't this all the expenses has to be added to the cost of transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges as per rule 2, sub rule 2, as per rule 10, sub rule 2, why? Any expense to the place of importation to bring it here. Whatever expenses are going to be incurred has to be added in the value. I hope you're getting my point. To bring it at this point, whatever expenses you are doing will have to be added. All this four will be part of your transportation as per rule 10 sub rule 2. And insurance, they have given 20,000. Simple question. What need to be done? Take 20 lakhs plus 5 lakhs, which comes to 25 lakhs is your custom FOB. Then in this, sea freight 45,000. Ship demurrage charges is 10,000. Litterage charges. What is litterage? Litterage is 25,000. What is 25,000 over here? Charges incurred. For unloading, you can write over here. Just write. Litterage means, write. Litterage means, or litterage means unloading charges. Unloading charges at the outer anchorage. Write. Write. Litterage means unloading charges at the outer anchorage. Am I clear? Then barrage is 50,000. What is 50,000 over here? To bring the lift from outer anchorage to jetty, right over here. Barrage means to bring lift from outer anchorage to jetty. I hope you're with me. Yes or no? Yes, this comes to 50. Total is 1,30,000 plus actual cost of insurance is 20,000. Total CIF value is 26,50,000. I hope you're with me. In this question, what is new? This transportation. That's it. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Is the question clear? Is question number 7 clear? Come to next question. Question number 8. Computation of assessable value and import duty from the following information given below. Date of presentation of bill of entry is 20th of June and date of arrival of goods is 30th of June. See boss, these two dates are important for me to identify the custom duty, BCD rate. BCD will be whichever is later, 30th June, this one. But my exchange rate will always be bill of entry. My exchange rate will always be bill of entry, and that too given by CBIC, not by RBI. Boss, I am doing export import over here, so I want a rate given by CBIC, Central Board of Indirect Tax and Customs. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. Then 12%, they have given 37. They have given CIF now. This question. CIF value $2,000 they have given. Air freight they have given 500. Insurance cost they have given 100. Now what will come to your mind? Ma'am, why they have given? What will you do? You will take the CIF. You will take the CIF. Simple. You will multiply the CIF with 66 rupees. You will get CIF in INR. And on this you will start calculating your what? Custom duty. It will become wrong. Boss, air freight. Don't miss this. Air freight. Air freight is what? Actuals or 20% of FOB, whichever is lower. So from CIF, I'll be subtracting 500. I'll be subtracting 100. I am getting 1400. 1400 is what my FOB. 1400, 20% comes to 280. Yes or no? 280 or 500 air freight, whichever is lower. So what are you going to do? You will be getting this 1400. From that, you have taken this 280. Now, in this 1400, you will be adding 280 plus 100. That means your CIF value is 1780. Please, this is just one. I had to just teach you this one point in this question. Rest you all know. What will be doing? This CIF, you'll be converting into INR. You'll be getting INR, CIF in INR. Then you'll be calculating basic custom duty at the rate of 10%. Then you'll be applying social welfare surcharge. I've made myself very clear. Social welfare surcharge, irrespective of the fact whether it's given in the question or not, it will be there because social welfare surcharge is on BCD. BCD is there. Social welfare surcharge will be there. Am I clear? Then on total, you'll be applying integrated tax. I hope you're with me. So simple, in this question, you have to just keep in mind this point. And I think landing charges, not a certain level. Why do I need landing charges? I don't need any post-importation expenses. I need transportation, loading, unloading and handling charges to the place of importation. And I need insurance to the place of importation. Am I very clear? Is this question very clear? Is illustration 8 very clear? Can I go ahead? Okay. Come to next illustration. Illustration number 9. computation of import duties of customs. Compute the custom duty table from the following information given below. Okay. Machinery import from USA by air. Please. Air, freight, actuals, or 20%, whichever is low. Boss, half job is done if you've read the question thoroughly. Don't rush while reading the question. If you read the question, while reading only, mark, okay, here I can do a mistake. I have to emphasize. The moment air you see, na, just write there 20% or actuals. Or actual, whichever is lower. This why I'm saying this, because when attempts would happen while reading, that point was there, but while solving it may happen that you have it's not in your mind. Better to write it down. Okay. Second point, this is important. This topic I'm going to cover later, but I'm just going to explain it over here. SREs worth $2,000 compulsory supplied with machine. Price is included in the price of machine. See, they're talking about SREs. Now, question over here, I'll tell you what can be a problem. On machine, custom duty rate is 10%. On SREs, custom duty rate is 20%. Now, what mistake you can do? On this, you will apply 10%. On this, you will apply 20%, which will be wrong. Understand? For this accessories, they have not charged anything separately. It's already added in the value of the machine. So two conditions. One, something is compulsory. Any spare parts, any maintenance equipments, any accessories which are compulsory. One. Second, for that, separately you have not charged. It's already included in the value of the product. So on that SREs, what will be the rate of custom duty? The rate of the product will be the rate of custom duty. Students can do a mistake. Students can do like this. 10,000 minus 2,000, which comes to 8,000. On 8, they may apply 10%. On 2,000, they may apply 20%. Galat, wrong. No. Clearly, it's going to come. It's there in this chapter. One, two conditions compulsory. First condition, that it is compulsory to supply that spare parts, that equipment, material, whatever, maintenance equipments or SREs. One. Second, no separate value has been charged. It's already there in the value of the machine. In that case, for accessories, whatever rate is on that main product, that rate will be applied on accessories also. In short, full 10,000, it will be 10%. Am I very clear? Am I clear? Okay. Air freight, 3,000. Actually, it's 3,000. I hope you're with me. Okay, let's see. Insurance. Okay. Local agent commission is 4,500 rupees. Boss, you can't add rupees in dollars. Currency has to be same. And air freight and insurance are my 10-2 adjustments. And 10-2 adjustments are done on custom FOB. And custom FOB comes after rule 10, subrule 1 adjustments. Okay, nothing else is given. Simple. Take the machinery value. Convert it into INR, 6 lakhs. On that, add agency commission. So now you're getting FOB as per customs, which is 6,4,500. Now, cost of insurance is actuals. Air freight, 20% or custom FOB, whichever is lower. Your custom FOB is lower, 120. CIF value comes to 731,400, and now you can calculate your custom duty. Am I very clear? See, what have I done? 10,000, and on this 10,000, I've taken BCD 10%. Please, very important question. Just one second point with this, and 1 8 point can create problem for you in the whole question. Am I clear? Can I go ahead?
Okay.
Okay. Come to question number 10. PQ Industries Limited has imported certain equipments from Japan at an FOB cost of 2 lakh yen. The other expenses incurred by Mrs. PQ are as follows. Freight from Japan to Indian port. Okay, this is to the port of India is 20,000 yen. Insurance paid to insurer in India for the importation of machine rupees 10,000. Okay. Designing charges paid in Japan will be added. Mrs. PQR Limited has spent 1 lakh rupees in India for certain development charges with respect to import machine. Boss, India. So this will not be added. Then PQR Industries Limited had incurred road transport costs from Mumbai port to their Karnataka factory. Boss, this is after coming to India. This again will not be added. Your rate is 1 yen is 0.65 rupees as per CBI. So, I'm going to take CBI's rate only. Okay. Then, Mrs. Speaker's definitive. What payment rate you have done? I am not concerned with this. Commission payable to agent in India was 5% of FOB of Indian rupees. I hope you're with me. Simple question. Take yen 20, take machine 2 lakh yen. On that 2 lakh yen, I hope you're with me. I hope you're with me. I would have not added this freight over here. Okay, let me solve this question in my way. Okay, I would have taken FOB over here. FOB over here. FOB is how much? 2 lakh yen. Am I clear? 2 lakh yen. Are you okay with me? Okay. Let's take FOB. It's 2 lakh yen. We'll see. My answer and their answer will match in the end. But we'll have a same format. In that case, what will happen? That even if I change in the right format also, my answer will always be same. Freight, as of now, I'm not going to do anything. Insurance, as of now, I'm not going to do anything. Design, yes, I'll be adding. So this will come to 30,000. Designing, I will be adding 10 subrule 1, which comes to 30,000 yen. Okay. Then, this is done. This I'm not going to add. This I'm not going to add. Fine. CBIC rate, custom duty is 0.65. Fine. Okay. But commission is payable in INR. So first I want 0.65. So it's 2,30,000 yen. What is the currency rate? 0.65. So 2,30,000 into 0.65 comes to 149,500. On that, I have to add commission at the rate of 5%. Commission will be on what? Cost of equipment. So 2 lakh into 0.65 into 5%. 2 lakhs into 0.65 into 5% comes to 6,500. So if I add this, I will get my custom FOB is 1,56,000, and now they're saying that freight. Okay, when it's saying port, that means not airport, it's port, it's water, actuals. So 20,000 into 0.65, 20,000 into 0.65 comes to 13,000. And insurance again in rupees only 10,000. So 1,56,000 plus 13,000 plus 10,000 comes to 1,79,000 is my CIF value, which should match with this answer. Yes, got the point. See, don't change your format. Don't change your format. First, always rule 10, sub rule 1 adjustment. If I add this over here, I'll unnecessarily get confused. So don't do this. Do this method. If I want, I can present it properly again. So let's take FOB. How much? 2 lakh yen. I hope you're with me. Then add designing charges. How much asking us to design? Is 30,000 yen. Yen 30,000, which comes to 2,30,000. I've multiplied by 0.65. So now I'm getting how much? 149,500, which is rupees. 149,500. Then I've added commission, which is machines 5%. So 2 lakh into 0.65 into 5%, which comes to how much? 6,500. 6,500. By doing this, I will get custom FOB. Custom FOB is how much now? 1,56,000. And on custom FOB, I'll be adding 10 to. First is transportation, which they're given in yen, which is how much? In the question, 20,000 yen. So 20,000 into 0.65, which comes to, I think, 13,000, right? Yes, 13,000. And in this second, I'll be adding insurance, which is given in INR only. 10,000 till comes to 1,79,000. This is my CIF value. I hope you're getting my point. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Boss, if you have same format matters a lot. If format is fixed here, no, you will never do mistake. Am I clear? Why I have not added this point? Because it's done in India. Why I have not added this point? Because this is after coming to India. I'm going to add all expense to the place of importation. Am I clear to you? Sure. Am I clear to you? So boss, by this we are done with the question which is relevant to rule 3 plus rule 10. And now we'll start with those part where in rule 12 my value is rejected, and when my value is rejected, I'll have to go to rule 4 to rule 9 sequentially. Am I clear to you? Sure. Can I go ahead?